Hello and welcome everybody to the Join the League season number 3. Two giants going up against each other in the jDL Asia Division 1, Arrow Gaming and Titan. Most likely the two strongest teams of the Southeast Asian scene, and Titan of course. They even have Mushi playing for them nowadays. Not too sure if it's a permanent thing or not, but we will see. Anyways, we are HeflaTV, I am Coucher, and today I'm joined by Heflamok. If he's around at least. He's busy just organizing stuff.
I'm here, hello guys, but I'm just super busy because at the moment we are online with four channels on the entire HeflaTV label, and like I have to assign so many things, that's why I'm gonna leave Coucher alone for the next 3-4 minutes till I fixed everything, and then I will join you. But yeah, I'm glad to be here, and this is gonna be an amazing game.
Yeah, it most certainly is, or at least it should be, by all means. It's the Southeast Asian El Clasico, I guess, or one version of it. But looking at the draft, so far, nothing out of the ordinary, as I guess from the first bans, you can't really expect too much, just crazy stuff happening. Doombringer taken out by Arrow Gaming, whereas Death Prophet by Titan. I would expect a Lycan getting banned out as well. Some teams though just don't care about it all. In the Mushi challenge, the Mushi plus 4, I guess, 3 Titan members there, they also completely overlooked Lycan for one game, but it was when they were Radiant, or they were Dire rather, so it was a Radiant Lycan, and they just crashed it. But we'll see how well, or if it's gonna get banned or picked up even potentially. Razor, also a viable ban I guess from Arrow Gaming at the moment. It's like Razor, Shadow Shaman, Faceless Void of course is yet to be banned as well. Just way too many strong heroes out there at the moment. But we'll see, Arrow Gaming. It's a tough decision. Lycan, Faceless Void, Razor. Sometimes some teams even ban out Shadow Shaman or Skywrath Mage straight out. Just any of those heroes is definitely ban worthy, as well as just first phase pick worthy, but they ban out a Tidehunter instead. So Titan, they go for a Razor and Arrow. Are they gonna go for the Dire Lycan, or is this gonna be one of those games where the teams are like, yeah, the Lycan, it can be stopped, guys. It's not as strong as it used to be, or people or the current meta game just kind of works against it a little bit. Although if you have like Lycan, Shadow Shaman, if you only had the Death Prophet on top of that as well, which of course was banned out already, it could have been just the most amazing Death Ball push ever. But no Death Prophet at the very least. So Faceless Void the first pick. Is it going to be the Skywrath Mage combination, or do they prefer the Ancient Apparition for example, or no, they go for Invoker straight out just to make sure it doesn't get banned. I mean, yes, Invoker is pretty strong. If it's a mid lane matchup up against the Razor, an Exort Invoker definitely can just hold his own somewhat. Razor, once he comes with the Static Link, you can either use Cold Snap to just make him back off, or just stay at really far distance, maybe even stay up on your own high ground. So Razor just can't come harass you with the Static Link, at least not as favorably. And of course Forge Spirit's helping out as well on the counter harass onto Razor, as well as just getting the last hits, even if your own damage is stolen. And not to mention the combination, Chaos Meteors, Sunstrike, Deafening Blast, all of it into the Chronosphere. It's one of the deadliest combinations really, if you can land the combo, but that's a big if. But Titan, they go for a Witch Doctor second pick. Holy crap. That's something I did not see coming, I have to say. Witch Doctor second one. I mean, I love that hero. Paralyzing Cask can be an extremely strong ability, of course, if you just get a little bit lucky with the bounces or your timing is just impeccable. And the heal, definitely not a bad thing to, like, for example, sustain pushes, or just you fight, you win it, and just with the Wood Restoration heal, you can guarantee that you can keep on going, get some objectives after that. That's Arrow Gaming. They do ban out the Lycan now, at the very least, as the third one. Little bit surprised that they didn't go for it, being on the Dire side and all, but they want the Wombo combo instead of a Titan though. The bans came out rather fast, usually it slows down a little bit in the second phase, but Center Warrunner as well as a Skywrath Mage taken out almost immediately by them. So Arrow, is it going to be something like a Shadow Shaman ban now, taking out the secondary support here? Or actually they ban out a Dazzle. That's a hero that definitely has the ability to just save people even when they're in the Chronosphere, just Shallow Grave them up, keep them alive with the Shadow Waves. And the minus armor aspect of Weave, plus of course the plus armor on their own heroes, could have been something somewhat annoying to deal with. Especially if the Weave, if you're just ticking down with the minus armor an incredible amount. Just Razor, Eye of the Storm on top of that all of a sudden. it's so easy to bring you down. But Pat already picked up Ferrero Gaming, so they just went for straight out, free cores, no hesitation at all, whereas Titan, they have the two supports now, Disruptor and the Witch Doctor. Disruptor is going to be good against the Batrider. Fairly decent up against the Faceless Void as well. You can just glimpse him back. When he comes in, Chrono suddenly glimpsed and he can't do any damage at all himself at the very least. Static Storm, also a great ability. At the moment, they don't have the best setup for it. I mean, Paralyzing Cask, yes, but a little bit luck-based. They don't have anything like a Ravage to just throw out and then follow up with a Kinetic Field Static Storm. So, we'll see. We will see how they want to just go about this now. They still have two cores to pick up. Titan, that did Bazaar, Arrow Gaming, oh man. Ancient Apparition now to come out as well. They have plenty of lockdown between their heroes now. Just Ancient Apparition, Cold Feet, can proc when you use LSO. Maybe even with the Cold Snap if you get enough procs of it. Just four spirits right-clicking away. They have a rather well-balanced lineup so far. They have the gank, they have the chomp, and I really love that they actually do not rely 100% on the Faceless Void chest. Going in with the Time Lock and getting a huge Chronosphere. They can also start with the Batrider, but a Chaos Knight pickup for Titan. Holy crappers. Man, I just love to be honest that, although yes, the majority of the heroes are still the same, at least the first phase goes almost just 100% the same, the bans, the picks. But things have definitely started opening up. People have gone more aggressive, just experimenting with extremely weird lineups, I guess you can put it like that. But it's all fine. And that just goes to show that even though the patch doesn't come out, Dota is just such a volatile game. Just changes from left and right.
Left and right, you say, and I'm back. Like, I guess I am. Like, Jesus Christ, today is a crazy day. Like, three channels online in the English one, working on the Heroes of the Storm channels at the same time. Our Chinese stream has some Twitch or OBS problems and all the tickering in the background. So much work to do for me today. Either way, this is going to be an amazing game, and I just look at the draft and, whoa, this is an amazing draft. I just see a Chaos Knight. Alone for that fact, I'm already excited.
Yeah, I mean, Chaos Knight, definitely a hero that at least used to be in the past, just, it's like IO Chaos Knight. If there's no IO, no Wisp, there's no Chaos Knight. But that has changed up a little bit. Actually, I've seen a moderate amount of Chaos Knights, I even have to say. I mean, I can't say I've seen it as much as the Disruptor, of course, but the Chaos Knight, it's making a comeback of sorts. Especially thanks to the Phantasm buff, you have that 50% chance of just creating an extra illusion.
I never understood what that buff is supposed to be, because maybe it's just me always having, like, you know, the dirty side of the coin, because I never get any additional phantasms when I play that game. But, well, I guess you can call it a buff, but for me it's just too RNG. Even 50% is too RNG.
RNG always works in your favor if you play that hero all the time. You get to be friends with that hero, so
Okay, so you think it's my personal attitude towards the hero that doesn't give me extra phantasms.
Yeah. You got to pat him and feed him and...
Ah, okay, that makes sense, Kaoju.
It's like a Tamagotchi.
it's a Chaos Tamagotchi. Okay, well, but either way, like, looking at all this, I mean, we have a Chrono, but, like, what I'm really missing is some external damage into it. I mean, maybe there has been some Firefly before. Man, of course, we have the Ice Blast.
Ice Blast and Invoker, that's plenty of external damage. Yeah.
But of course, I wanted to see the Witch Dog or the Scarab Mage or anything like that, like one of those best.
Well, Witch Doctor was picked up by Titan straight after the Invoker as the second pick. And of course, Scarab Mage was banned, so.
Yeah. I guess it would work. I mean, right now, like, I'm just looking what lockdown they have. And I mean, Disruptor, okay, that's not, you know, not always 100% lockdown with the Kinetic Field. Chaos Knight, that's a stun, but also RNG-based. I mean, it's at least 2 seconds and in the higher levels. But the Witch Dog, like, the problem is we have quite some interrupt right now. I mean, if the Witch Dog is channeling, like, Cold Feet could proc. We have the Batrider with Flame Break, Lasso, Fissure, Totem, Aquaslam, Invoker can interrupt as well with multiple abilities. And, of course, we have the Chrono plus Bashes. So this Witch Dog getting through his Death Ward, that will be quite a task.
Yeah, I mean, he's... positioning has to be just 100% perfect, more or less. Or he just has to wait out everything, hopes that he survives the onslaught, and then goes for the Death Ward after all the Chronospheres and everything has been used. But that chance is really small. But Titan, they finish it up with a Warlock. Ohio picks it up as well, who is their offlane player. Do you think that this means that it's going to be an aggressive tri-lane, or is it actually going to be offlane Warlock?
Why not mid warlock? No, it's Ohio, so it has to be.
What do you actually think overall of the warlock? If the Faceless Void comes in with the initiation, you just drop the Chaos Offering in return and hope for the best, or?
I don't know. I've seen about three warlocks being played in Pro Dota like the last week alone, and to be honest, neither of them really, I don't know, convinced me of that hero. It's just, I don't know, too vulnerable, that hero. The heal, yes, is a cool thing, but the chains is always a bit RNG. Sometimes getting them off is quite hard. For laning, it's quite nice. The ultimate as such, it feels strong at the start, and of course that stun overall is quite nice, but then even with Aghanim Scepter, and maybe even Refresher later, like, it just feels like the longer the game goes, like, the more uses that Warlock feels, while other ultimates, they are still quite nice, but first, let's see what we got here, because the Batrider, very awkward position.
Yeah, he should be fine. Mushi couldn't quite get in range, and of course, Xiangxi started with Boots of Speed as well. But speaking of the players, I guess we can introduce them as well. As for Arrow, Xiangxi will be playing the offlane Batrider, leaving DDZ, of course, to play on his Invoker in the mid lane, with the supports taken up by Mozen up on the Earthshaker. MTR, their new captain, the player for them, just replacing Johnny, is MTR, and Lance on the Faceless Void in the safe lane.
Yep, absolutely. And, well, still in the jungle somewhere, he is the Ohio Warlock here, the guy we talked just about. And, well, let's see how this is going to be. Then in the mid at the moment, or crossing the mid, is, of course, Extinct here on the Warlock. And in front of him, there is Net on the Disruptor. My friend KYXY is on the Razor in the mid. And Mushi is going to be in that try line, the farming part on the Chaos Knight. Yep, let's see how Mushi is going to do. I mean, we casted the G1 Gigabyte challenge here, and was amazing games, like over 20,000 people tuned in just to see Mushi and like this challenge played. And I mean, okay, WTF was part of it. Now we have actually like four people off Titan instead of only three. But I don't think the performance will change too much. So, yep, Titan looking good in the last days.
It's just, okay, at the moment, it's the orange from TI3, the lineup. So,
yep, I guess pretty much. Yeah, it's orange. Volume 2.
And to be honest, if they can play as well as they did at TI3, they should be just golden. And like you already said, in the Mushi challenge, they showed that exactly. They just even have one more support now with them Extinct, so their team synergy should be just up there 100%. But Arrow, they've been together for a really long time as well. And if Fisher comes out, they actually block them in as well, but no follow-up aggression at all.
Nah, I don't think they can do anything, especially if they're level 1. On level 2, it actually gets quite interesting for both try lanes. But for the other lanes, at the moment in mid, we just see the usual struggle for CS. The Razor is trying to, of course, drive DDC out there with the static link. He already did that once. On the offlane, well, that's the normal build. You should definitely go for Fatal Bonds all the time. And you see Xiangxi getting quite some damage here. Fatal Bonds, it's hurting so much, but he didn't go for Shadow Ward yet. So, I don't know, I think if he could go for it, we might have some, but
stats.
Top, look at top.
Man, Mushi, he's fine. Creeps, he doesn't care about creeps, he has his Dawichi Lord. Actually, does he care? Now the Chilling Touch comes out a little bit late. Lance wants to go for the Time Warp, he cancels it, there's the right clicks. Stun, 2 second, one onto Lance, he's taking so much damage. Who's gonna go down first? One more right click, Mushi. He's outrunning, but the Sun Strike, it gets the kill just after Lance actually dies himself. Extinct, one more right click, goes down as well. Wow, the Centaur, it stunned Mozen, man.
Yep, the neutrals playing a part here as well, so they couldn't follow up, but I don't think they even want to. They made a 2-1 trade, they got even the first blood here a tiny second earlier, so yep, you cannot complain if you're on Team Arrow at the moment. That was definitely good. You got the farmer killed, you got the first blood bonus, and even like a nice little cherry on top of the cake. And let's see, maybe there's more to come now.
Yeah, I mean, just DDZ, of course, getting the first blood as well, the Ruthless Sunstrike. Mushi otherwise would have 100% just ran away from there, I think. Should have been tanky enough. He has a magic stick picked up now, which is always nice up against the tri-lane. Just everybody spamming spells left and right anyway. But I think with Arrow, they got that small advantage. They're going to be able to hit level 3 a little bit faster probably because of this. Although Extinct, almost level 3 net is already, so has 1 point into each spell. Kinetic Field definitely might be something that will help them just either back off or just secure the kill.
Yep, absolutely. And well, in the mid so far, it's 12 and 9 for the Razor, and only 8 and 3 for DDZ, and DDZ even has to be really, really careful. Like, those level 2 plasma fields, they take him down really low. He's already on, like, 3 bubbles of Quas, trying to regen up a bit, but, well, with level 3 plasma field, he gotta be really aware of his HP.
He should be fine with the quas balls, at least. Just crazy amount of regeneration coming out from those already. Unfortunately, Invoker isn't really a hero that likes to go for a bottle. There are some certain players that still go for it, but definitely not too common, and thus, you really have to rely only on the quas regen. At least KYXY is low on mana as well. He is bottle crowing, but unless he finds a lucky regeneration rune, I think DDC, he can at least stay in lane and soak up some XP.
Yep, and at the moment, to be honest, I think the Trident of Arrow is doing, like, besides, of course, that little brawl at the start, but they're still doing a better job at the moment. Like, I mean, Mushi is 17 and 4, 11 on 3 on the Void, but, like, when it comes to harass damage, Lance, like, putting in here and there some right clicks on the Chaos Knight, and I'm just waiting for that Fisher that is, again, a nice block, as we already saw it on the first, like, little fight there. Like, if that Fisher comes, the Chaos Knight, he pretty much explodes, because that Chilling Touch and 3 targets hitting you, that is bad news for him.
Yeah, I mean, the Chilling Touch is such a strong ability in a situation like this. And it's level 2 by now as well, so 60 extra damage for 4 consecutive hits. Unless it times out, but it takes a really long time to time out, so if you're just going for the fight, you're most likely to use up all the charges.
Yep, absolutely, and well, so far they just focus on farming. Like, I wish, to be honest, that the Disruptor and the Witch Dog, like, they do some more harass damage on Lance. I think they could, but then again, they also run, like, maybe in an awkward position where Fisher comes out and they're all three stunned, and then that's bad news. Then we have maybe a triple slow by Lance here, with even with the level 1 time walk. That's just enough, but, well, let's see.
Yeah, man, KYXY me then as well just keeps on harassing. Actually, he did get that regeneration rune I was talking about, it, and he actually locked it out as well. So one more plasma field, back off and just go region up yourself with the bull. But bottom lane, yep. Xiangxi is actually struggling quite hard, Ohio. Does he really want to go for the kill? 2 points into Shadow Word, and he has the Chaotic Offering.
Yep, the Chaotic Offering. Like, he just needs to bring him low a bit, then the Shadow Word plus the Offering. That should be a kill on a Batrider, which is 700 HP. I mean, the only stat boosting item he got at the moment, that's a branch. That's pretty much all about it. And the Tranquil Boots, they're gonna be disabled pretty much all the time with the Warlock's range of right clicks. But let's see, at the moment it doesn't look like it. He's probably doing the side pull. Yep, he's doing it right now. And that brings the Batrider then a bit closer. Maybe you even see a rotation. One of those supports, for example, Ned there. Ned bringing the Batrider back with the Glimpse, I think that's the best rotation to make. Or maybe even the Witch Dog just to hold him in place, plus the Offering Stun. That might be our kill, or the kill we are looking for.
Yeah, I mean, Glimpse is definitely an ability that can be of great use when trying to chase down a Batrider. Usually Batriders, when in trouble, activate Firefly, go to the side of the map and just try to make it so that the enemy can't even spot you out, can't get any vision. But if you have the Thunderstrike on before, that gives you vision. Glimpse follow-up could be an easy kill indeed, but look at Xiangxi, he's just creep-skipping at the moment. He doesn't want to give Warlock any chance to actually get close to him.
Yep. Absolutely. He's well aware that, like, with the current setup or with the current level of the Warlock, for example, like, he couldn't do anything. And, well, it's also a bit standoff at the moment in the try line. Like, I thought we get more action out of this, but after this, like, little start brawl, we don't see anything happening. But I guess that's the way they want to play it for now. They're happy as it goes. And, I mean, if we have, like, a short glimpse just in the crafts, I mean, Titan is doing a tiny bit better when it comes to farming overall. But I'm not sure if that stays up. It's not an advantage you can really talk of. It's something that can change just with a double stack of creeps, for example.
Yeah, and actually, when both teams are farming up like they are at the moment, who do you think it actually favors? I mean, going into the mid game, and who also has the best late game? Actually, 1 second stun onto Lance. Mushi didn't luck out with the long stun, but coming back to the question, who does it favor at the moment, this just farming game?
That's a good question, to be honest. A question I couldn't even answer, because I think that the ultimates coming up at level 6 for Titan, they're quite potent, to be honest. I think they should make use of them, especially the Warlock one. But I mean, looking at the Warlock, well, we might see him doing something now. But top, they all rotated away. They want to go mid. They want to get KYXY with the Gangrai, pretty much.
Is it a little bit too obvious, though? I mean, his teammates should be like, KYXY, care, man, there's nobody on the top lane. But they want to go in plasma field, KYXY, he overextends a little bit. Gonna get Fisher, time locked. And yeah, KYXY, he's gonna go down. Actually, a few more right clicks, they finish it up. MTR gets the kill. A few time locks, even the cold feet level 1 proc there.
And but still, this is a lot of commitment for this. I mean, a 4-man gank in the mid, just to get one kill ahead, now that they already started working on the tier one tower top, they will lose this tower for sure. I don't think there's any rotation now. Even MTR has to be careful here. 70 HP. Fortunately, there's nothing global they can spam. So the tower top is going down, and well, in the mid, nothing's happening. So that's a kill for a tower. I don't know if that was really worth it.
I mean, economically, it definitely wasn't. KYXY did lose some valuable farming time, I guess, and TDC got some space for himself there. Has his hand off might have finished 8 minutes in about. Going into the jungle to farm up a little bit as well. But Mushi farming up on the bottom lane now. And the one thing is that Xiangxi, man, he's only 150 gold away from his Blink Dagger on the Pathrider. So he's gonna get it really damn fast here.
Yep, absolutely. And, well, Mushi is at least spotting Xiangxi here, but there's nothing you can do with a Batrider. Still half duration, but oh, we might see more soon. And he's getting stunned, but there might be a follow-up here. At least there's a Klim, so he should go down.
It should be really easy. Kinetic Field gonna keep him in play. Shadow Ward actually heals him up a little bit. He's still alive. Finally goes down, but net. Gonna be the counter kill as DDC's Force Spirit comes in. Now MTR running away from Mushi. One more right click. That's all he needs. I mean, the horse should be much faster than an ancient apparition. He's gonna get the kill as well. But Xiangxi, he's there. But his Blink Dagger, no. Is he gonna get caught? They have the Chaotic Offering. Do they want to pop it? KYX by Static Link. Drums. Oh, never mind. It was the Buckler instead.
No.
KYX Sunstrike. Oh, Sunstrike. Oh my god. Flame Break. Anything. Xiangxi, I know you want to go for it, but still Blink. It's coming out to him. He has it now. They're gonna get Mushi. Fisher isn't actually blocking him off. Oh, yes, it is, just barely.
But no, I think it's the right decision to go back there, but still, there's Net being followed here by DDC, but even DDC knows, oh, the entire team is wrapping around there. This is not a good decision to go for it, and yeah, I think Arrow made the right decision there, because with the Warlock still having the ultimate and the stick charges on Mushi, he got there from the Batrider, like, he still had a stun, and that was, yeah, overall a bad idea to go into it, like, yeah.
Well, this fight definitely is just favored Titan by the end of it. They did lose a little bit, and actually they're gonna get the tower here as well. Mushi has the heal from the Shadow Ward, tanks it up for a little while. Four Spirits coming in now with the DC Mozon, and even Lance is there, who has a Chronosphere. It's ready, he's level 7. It might be disastrous if they go in, but I don't know, at the very least, they don't have Ice Blast quite yet, although MTR, he's soaking up XP bottom lane.
Yep, it's just too bad I didn't have any vision around, like, the top rune here, because he could have just pulled Mushi there on the high ground here at the rune ward spot and just let him burn in fire, pretty much. But, yeah, Xiangxi prefers to just farm the camps here at the moment with his newly acquired Blink Dagger. I think they should also make something. It comes down to what I already said about Titan. I think we should have seen already, like, a Chaotic Offering, and also thought we might see a bit earlier that Lasso, but at the moment, well, he is level 8, and we haven't seen one yet, but this might change with the smoke they just did.
Yeah, they definitely want to get something. I mean, first Blink Dagger gank. I'm not too sure if Titan actually saw it when they were fighting it. Xiangxi, he got it, like, by the end of that fight. The courier brought it out to him. So Titan, they might not be aware, and, man, this smoke, I think it's gonna have a fairly high success rate, at least get one support down, Xiangxi. I'm expecting him to just Firefly. They see it, super easy, kill actually the glimpses back, Lasso. It gets cancelled, but the Chronosphere onto Extinct Witch Doctor, he's gonna go down. Chaotic Offering, he's actually there, Extinct. No, he goes down in the end anyway. Ice Blast to Fly Net, probably to fall for the Shatter and Xiangxi now. Actually, was it another glimpse?
Nope, that was just Flame Break knockback. And, well, in the end, it's a 2-for-1 try. The Batrider has to pay there for his insolence, but, well, you saw the Chaotic Offering coming out there. It couldn't prevent anything in the Chrono. It just, yeah, I know, with all the Ice Blasts and whatnot flying around, like, it was two kills nevertheless, but at least they use it now to go for the tier 1 tower, and I don't think there's anything they can do. Not even a deny attempt or Fisher coming out. So at least it's a 2-for-1 plus a tower on top, still a trade that doesn't really favor anyone here, because the two supports for the Batrider, that's okay, but you got the tower bonus on top of it, so it's fairly equal again.
Yeah, just look at Mushi's skill build at the moment as well. He's actually put 1 point into stats instead of maxing out Reality Rift. Usually it's like, when you're level 8, you have only Chaos Bolt and Reality Rift, and then you start going for the Phantasm. But not the case actually. Net mid lane might be in trouble. Lance is hanging around. Ice Blast to fly as well. Time walk in. It's gonna go for the right clicks, but what? Ice Blast actually didn't connect?
No, but he knows his team is coming around there. There's the connect field just to hold him in place, and now Lance, this is a bad position because he doesn't have a time walk. 3 seconds done and you're so down. It started as his aggression on Net, but Net, like, he played it absolutely right. He was just, he knew, like, without the Ice Blast, he's not gonna get me. So, he was just stalling time, and the rest of the team just got there.
Yeah, and this is gonna be another tower. The stun with the glimpse onto Petro. Actually, what? The glimpse destroyed the stun? Holy crap, Xiangxia is gonna make it out.
Oh, there's an ice blast landing on KYX, but oh no, it's not enough. Like, it didn't hit him, but I think the glimpse just disjointed that stun. Like, that was kind of them playing against each other. That was, of course, a bad thing to happen. Like, either or should have happened. Like, glimpse him after the stun or glimpse him then stun, but not at the same time, apparently.
Well, it is a little bit hard to just call it when you just barely get vision of the hero. You're just... Everybody wants to go for it. Everybody wants to set up the kill. But suddenly... A little bit unfortunate, but they did get the tower in the end, so 30 minutes in now. But looking at the net worth charges, DDZ, he's miles above everybody else on his invoker.
Yep, I didn't expect this one, that he is like really that far ahead. I mean, we haven't seen, apart from that one sunstrike that landed, and I don't know, we haven't seen so much from him, but farming wise, he's doing fine. I mean,
he went for a Rod of Athos.
Yes, Rod of Athos already up. As
I don't
well
think
as
I've ever seen it on invokers.
I've seen once a Rod of Aoi on an invoker, and that was like 2 weeks ago, but yeah, it's not a very common item, and well, let's see how this works out. I mean, I like Rod overall. It's an awesome item, especially against target that just, you know, run forth and back. I mean, slowing down like all of them is definitely worth it with a team that can, you know, just chase them or sometimes has to chase them. The only downside is, of course, on the Razor, you get always that feedback damage from the unstable current, but that's pretty much about it. Oh, but bottom lane, there we go.
He gets purged up, man, just as you were talking about the unstable current, but Lance is coming in as well. The Chronos are up onto two Ice Blast to follow. KYX by Sunstrike, he's gonna go down so damn fast. Chaotic Offering was used, Xiangxia gonna get caught. Actually, the Static Storm is a little bit off from his target, so he just Flame Breaks everybody back. They are alive, it's a 1-0 so far net. Oh man, Cold Snap, Force Spirit is completely wrecking him apart. And Lance goes down in the end as well.
Yep.
Ohio, he got it with a Shadow Word or just his pawns, but Ohio, is he good safe now? Pops the mech, but still taking way too much damage. Paralyzing Cast coming out as well from Extinct. TPs are there, but the Echo Slam, they stop Mushi from the initiation for a little second. MTR going to get ready to rift him. Mozen, another just... And he's still alive, finally goes down to the last right click. As the DDZ on the run, that would be such a high priority kill. Ice Wall down though, he's gonna be safe.
So yeah, that Ice Wall is just blocking him out. There's no chance.
Was it
3-2? Yeah.
3-2?
It was a 3-2 trade after all. But yeah, the Lance kill was actually... It was quite okay with the Ohio did there. Like, he focused with his Golem plus Shadow Ward and everything else just on Lance. And Lance, to be honest, the most damage came from the tower because he was going on trying to escape, like, in the north direction and got all the tower hits there, and even the last time war couldn't help him because the dot of the Shadow Ward was still ticking on him. So at least the Warlock soloed there the Void, but overall, I don't know, it was still a messy fight for Titan because the positioning was just horrible for them. Era had absolutely positioning advantage here, especially with the Fisher blocking them in and out, and even with the fast resupply of, well, like, reinforcements coming from the tier 1 or tier 2 tower with the TPs. You saw what happened, like the Earthshaker there, Echo Slam directly in Mushi's face, and with maybe some more follow-up, they would have even gotten him.
Yeah, that time with Mushi, he has himself a Vitality booster. Do you think it's gonna be a casual one until later on he finishes up the heart, or is he really going for straight-up heart, saying like, yeah, Arrow, they really don't have too much to deal with the illusions, I guess, unless all of the illusions just get Chrono, Ice Blast, and then Chaos Meteor, and Echo Slam,
no, I don't,
of course,
I don't think
on top
that's
of
a good
it.
Idea. Because he's still far away from a heart, unless he really finds a nice fight right now, which includes a lot of gold for him. I don't think that's a good idea. For now, it's a nice one, but oh, Chrono on free.
Yeah, Ohio might go down immediately. Sunstrike, Ice Blast to follow, the Chaos Meteor as well. Oh my god, damn, two heroes down. Mushi gonna get last ult as well before he does anything. Death Ward is there, Lance actually might go down. The last bounce is nope, the backtrack to Imba, as Xiangxia is also dropping low, but they just all survive 4-4 nothing. KYXY just barely TPs out, but man,
this
that
is
fight, that
bad
Chrono.
News. Yep, this is bad news. Like, Lance, he was so lucky, like by the time he was about to die, the backtracks just saved him, so he made it out of vision. And that death ward, that's the funny part, like, actually got a full duration through, but it's only a level 1 death ward, so it only brought, like, Lance really low, but he escaped, and the Batrider, well, he was, like, 300 HP or something. 2 more seconds channeling, that might have been a kill, but still, like, under... I don't know, the impression what happened before, that would have been just bad news. Like,
Mushi wants
bottom.
To go in DDZ, actually uses the Phantasm before the Chaos Ball. Now gonna get stunned up, Ice Blasted in the face. The MTR actually still hanging around to get the glimpse onto DDZ in the kinetic field, actually both of them, but where's the follow-up? 2 second Chaos Ball as DDZ gets a kill onto Mushi, just 4 spirits doing the work for him. And yes, They're taking such bad fights on okay, Woker. He wants to get the EDC. Oh man, is he gonna get it as well? Another nice feature, 4 staff. And Woker is gonna be safe, or is he KO? The offering, man, this commitment.
Yeah, this ultimate only for that, but now they might pay for it because, yep, look at Lance. He's coming in, focusing on Ohio here, but might not be a good idea because now he's getting a lot of damage with that Mask of Madness, but Xiang Sai doing so much fire damage and those stacks on him. Ohio is the first one to fall. KYXY maybe trying to do make something, but he's standing in the fire at the moment, so he gets at least a Batch Rider, but Lance, well, he's getting that kill. Another Ice Blast to follow, but there's nothing left. To be honest, Titan, that was a very, very questionable engagement overall, because Mushi went there with Net alone, tried to fight that while the others were still on the way in the jungle. By the time they arrived, Mushi was down from a shatter, Net was blocked in. By the way, those fishers, value fishers, all three of them were such a so amazing fishers, because they didn't get the invoker there, like the stun didn't hit, or when the stun came out there was deafening blast, everything, and then even the two follow-up fishers, they made so much, I don't know, how can you describe it? Cock-block fishers. They were everything
that's
in this
exactly
fight,
what they did, to be honest. And just look at the graphs now. XP 12,000 lead, and Lance, he wants to go for more. He has the Chrono Sphere. Time walking, actually. He doesn't want to pop the Chrono only onto one hero. He's gonna go for it anyway in the end. Ohio, Sunstrike, will he follow? Actually, the Deathport Silence up onto Lance. Kinetic Field, Static Storm. Can they get the counter somehow? I think they can. He's just gonna go for the kill anyway. Went for the Ohio. And, I mean, a 1-for-1 in the end. But I guess Arrow, they were definitely expecting to just get away scotch-free from that, but Titan, yeah, they were there to react.
To be honest, Ohio is not the best target to focus for that. He was expecting, like, yeah, Ice Blast, Sunstrike, my Chronosphere, some hits, and everything's gonna be fine there, but with the Death Ward, and then the Warlock even surviving, like, giving him a Shadow Word, like, he would have even died if there was a Time Walk out. So, in the end, I don't know if that's really a good trade. Like, the Chrono committed and then the Void down for Warlock. Well, he really thought he's getting out with this, but no, he did not, and it remains a 1-1. It doesn't change the fact that Arrow is leading by quite something now. Not just 9 kills, like an experience that is 12k, and that is quite heavy. And oh my god, Sunshine looking for Mushi in the mid, but not hitting, but still, he's getting really, really close,
I mean,
to that
shot range. He was trying to battle the Forge Spirits, but just completely got owned by them.
Yep.
Then the Ice Blast came out. I'm just waiting for Arrow, to be honest, to go for Roche now, maybe get the Aegis and just go balls deep into a fight. I mean, they have a Blink Dagger now on Earthshaker as well.
Yep. This was the first level 2 Ice Blast, by the way. So you see on Mushi, even with the casual Wit Booster, Strength PTs, and of course the drums, he's still quite susceptible to it, especially if he battles some Forge Spirits before that. And I think Arrow, they want to make the next step. I mean, they got the tier 1 towers in mid and bottom already, and now top tier 1 it is. The question is now, is Titan fighting this? Because the last fights, they were everything but favorable for them. I don't know if they really want to go for it. Then again,
Well, with the item pickup that Mushi just got, I think they want to fight a Blink Dagger Chaos Knight. It's happening,
oh my
man.
God. Blink now Dagger the Chaos. Shit is getting real.
But 4-man Smoke Man, they have to go soon. Tower already down. DDC gonna get Blink Chaos. Fault actually, Phantasm as well. Static Storm, all of it committed. Death Ward as well. 4 ultimates. Mushi actually dodges the Ice Blast. Thank God for him. But still taking a lot of damage from the Forge Spirits. Oh man. If he had actually gotten hit by the Ice Blast, might have died. But Blink Chaos Knight.
Blink Chaos Knight, new meta. And it's working. They got a 1-0 trade. And of course, it's a high value kill. Just for the fact that DDC, like, is so high in level, so high in farm, like, stopping him, it was about time. It really was about time. I mean, this guy at the moment leads by almost 5k in net worth. Like, he is 5k ahead of the second farmer, and the second farmer is the Razor at the moment, 7.5. It was really, really needed.
Holy crap, man. MTR. He's level 11, has an Aghanim Scepter on, the Ancient Apparition now. Those Ice Blasts, they're just gonna completely wreck Titan. Yes, they have the mech, but if you get hit by an Ice Blast, it doesn't help at all. There's no BKBs coming out anytime soon, by the looks of it. No pipe, no nothing. But how do they fight the Warlock? He's getting rather close, only 1,000 away from his Aghanim Scepter, so that might be helpful enough. Although, just Arrow, they're so far ahead at this point in the time.
Yep, but Titan, they're not in the mood of giving up today. Like, we might actually see another Plink initiation here by Mushi. The only problem is, like, this mid-observer ward scouted out everything. They saw they were going to the enemy jungle, and now Batrider is scouting, saw them. So Arrow is well aware of the fact that they are around. The entire team is behind DDZ. They might even use DDZ as a bait.
Yeah, they get the stun 4 second chaos bolt onto DDZ, but it was the perfect bait. 4 man chronosphere, ice blast to follow, chaos meteor, defending blast, they're just all completely down. KYXY was so far in the chronosphere, so he survived for a little while longer, but goes down in the end. Mushi is on the run, but Blink Mozart Echo Slam in the face. The creep wave just arrived.
This bait. Like, to be honest, like, this fight and everything, this was, like, we don't even need to talk about it. I mean, this was just a logical conclusion of a good chronosphere and a good bait, but this observer ward here in the mid, this is what made this all possible. Like, they saw them go in there, the Batrider just confirmed they are somewhere there. DDC showing, and Mushi actually fell for the bait, feeding the entire team there. Of course, some credit also to the Void that he actually got the entire team, everything but Mushi. This is the easy setup you can have. Freeman Chrono, Ice Blast, all of that.
Yeah, and Lance has a BKB finish now as well on the face. So it Mozen blinking. Oh man, Fisher into Sunstrike. Bye bye, Extinct. Actually, Glimpse back, they want to get Mozen. Can they do so? I think they can, although Lance is gonna come in. Mask of Madness activated. Flame Break as well. Static Storm is down, but no kinetic fields. Mushi, gonna Real Drift onto MTR. He has 3 or 2 Phantasm Illusions as well. A few more Reckless, that's all he needs. He's gonna get MTR at the very least. Or is he actually still chasing him down, Cold Feet? They aren't gonna proc, but.
It's a mega kill. Jesus Christ, like this Ancient Apparition wasn't a mega kill, so yeah, good news for Mushi here, at least he got the bonus kill, but still, like, 2 supports for 1, and this was just a base defense, the tower got about 50% damage, that's it, and I guess Titan, yeah, the problem is at the moment you can't lean back and say like, hey guys, we just farm and then wait for impending doom, no, they have to fight and just not fall for these baits. The only problem is, like, I mean, the Witch Doc had some sentry wards, but I don't know where he put it. Ah, he put them in the enemy jungle there, but well, at least KYXY is doing something now on the tower, maybe securing some more gold for Titan. They are still not out of the game, but of course it's bad news.
Yeah, they get the lasso as well onto Razor. Mushi is gonna come in for the help, really drift, but Flame Break back lands. Another Chronosphere up onto 2 this time. Mushi is barely out of it, but he's gonna just get bursted. Yule Scepter set up from DDC himself, therefore it's not gonna be enough. They pop the Chaotic Offering as well. They need something out of it, they need the returns. Glimpse back onto Mozen. Kinetic Field actually stopping them, so Lance, though, time walks in net. Is he gonna go down? Ice Vortex to slow them a little bit. Extinct.
Damn jukes!
And he's gonna go down. Flame Break. A few more right clicks. No running. Tornado. Yeah.
Man, yeah, this tornado is gonna finish
Ultra
it.
Ultra kill.
But yeah, like, Titan is every time they just come close to Arrow, they just get bashed. Bashed as in bridge slapped. It's. Yeah. And to be honest, like, in this fight, I would give the Void completely the credit for it, just for the fact that he got Razor as well as the Warlock. The two people that are, like, really dangerous for them, as in, like, maybe screwing with their team setup. Like, he got them in the Chronosphere, and there was nothing. I mean, you saw, by the time the Chaotic Offering came out, like, Mushi was dead. The Razor was pretty much dead. I think just 100 damage left or so. So, yeah, you need the Warlock to stay back a bit further, I guess, and then just, yeah, wait for that initiation. But the problem is now, I think it's a bit too late for all this. I mean, this all sounds good on paper that Titan would still have a chance, but 14k in gold and more than 20k in experience, I don't think you can easily come back from this. Like, they have to really make some elaborate plan. And I think turtling it and then hoping for the best while defending is, I guess, the way to go for it.
Yeah, I mean, at the moment, just the design of Titan's lineup, they are definitely not meant to come back or just struggle. They were the ones going for an aggressive tri lane, and even their just heroes were rather aggressive. Maybe they could have had a better one instead of the Disruptor, I guess, potentially. But all in all, Arrow, they just kept on farming on DDZ. Xiangxi went for that rather fast Blink Dagger about 9 minutes in or so. And they just start taking fights pretty much after the Blink Dagger came out. That one smoke to set things up, I think it was the bottom lane fight. And this game is just completely snowballing, and Lance is even going for an Agony Scepter now.
Yeah, I mean, they have the luxury that they can go for whatever. And I mean, Lance at the moment, like, I mean, I mentioned it multiple times that the Chronospheres that were really, really good. And now looking at, like, Agony Scepter, some moderation, sure, why not?
Just look at where Titan is. They're at the tier 2 tower, they don't want to go kill it, they want to bait it out. But MTR, yep, the only one who is around, and I mean, that's a good thing about Ancient Apparition as well. He can just be at other lanes, because the farther you are from a teamfight, the bigger area Ice Blast will affect. But finally Titan, they're gonna go in, it's like, yeah, it's not worth actually waiting as 5 and not farming.
Yeah, sick of waiting for it. While DDC, they're doing the same scheme they did all the time. DDC standing in front, like just baiting it out, doing a lot of damage on a tier 2 tower. And other rotations are coming in, but this might be even a bad idea. In theory, Xiang Xi could get Mushi out there.
Actually, oh, he's gonna go for the net instead. He didn't want to pop his PKB. He actually waited for the DDC. He's gonna get dirty through the flame break with the Fisher. You'll set up onto the DDC. Can he escape? Oh, the chaotic offering came out alongside the with his PKB Mozart. Echo slammed up, but he slowed down from the upheaval. Extinct. Suddenly, the mech keeps him alive for the time being, but the Chaos Meteor, it still kills KYXY. Mozart, he actually goes down in return, but Xiang Xi went a little bit greedy there. Does make it out and tower
and
down.
And Mushi dies in the base. He shattered, so that makes it a 3-1 trade. And to be honest, I have to say DDZ Invoker, too strong at the moment. Like, he makes all the plays, keeping it in place. Like, the Fisher, he knows exactly when to drop his meatball, the meteor, just through three people doing almost maximum damage you can do on that. And oh, another chrono.
Oh my god, are you kidding me? Sunstrike, extinct down almost immediately. They're gonna go for Ohio next. They need to get the Warlock. The Glimpse comes out. No BKB this time around for the Battle Rider anymore, so Ohio. He survives, or does he Ice Blast to fly with the Tornado coming out as well? He's gonna go down. No heal from the Shadow World and lands. Time Walk up onto net. Another easy kill. The entire team is dead. Probably Rex to follow, man. This game is GG.
I think this might be really the tipping point. I mean, before that I was like, yeah, maybe. But oh, Mushi's going in. 2 seconds stun here on DDZ. That's not really impressive, but maybe they try something. DDZ, there's a slow EMP. Everything's coming out, but he's getting glimpsed back and now... Well, that is bad news for him. He's stalling some time with his Yule Scepter, but 4 stuff up on the high ground. Beautiful place at the moment coming out, but Death Ward. Xiang Xi, PKB doesn't help you there, and well, let's see. DDC is still not out of this.
Yeah, I think it's gonna go down. They're gonna catch him. Ice Blast actually fights Lance. Gonna come in as well. The right clicks came away. Actually, he goes down before the Glimpse actually affects Lance at all. So they do get the counter. DDC, he buys back as well. Oh, Sunstrike! Oh, damn.
Buyback Sunstrike, the oldest thing to happen, but Mushi did not react. Lance was even looking for something more. He's going really, really ballsy. I mean, sure, he can. He is a BKB, Faceless Void, level 18, 30 minutes in with Aghanim Scepter pretty much or almost finished. And of course, the Aegis just helping him there. But, well, I mean, it was a tasty kill on those heroes, sure. And now the DDZ bought back, also a bit loss in net worth and everything, but still... They just continue. They just continue. And unless DDZ dies now somewhere immediately, this is maybe Rex or more.
Yeah, I mean, there's still a 25 second cooldown on Chaotic Offering as well. Lance, I actually feel like he wants to die just to get the mana back to use all of his spells properly. I mean, he has the Aegis after all, so he can definitely afford the luxury of dying at the moment. But Four Spirits, even the Glyph comes out, they want to defend Mushi's around, but they don't want to just commit on the guy with the Aegis, really.
Yep, the Aegis is reclaimed in a minute, and for that duration, Lance will just come in, maybe even just do jump in, make a awesome chrono. Like, unfortunately, they don't have a ward here, like, because, yep, Titan is well aware of the fact that they already stomped the Sentry Ward in their base, because if they had Vision, then the Batchrider and the Void, of course, can do an easy job. I think they have to get this Vision very, very fast, because then it's an easy game for Arrow.
Xiang Xi, you're gonna get the lasso to KYXY. They're just waiting it out. Ice Blast to fall only onto that one hero. It's gonna be worth it if they get the kill. BKB on Lance as well. And indeed, they get the kill. Lance gonna go in. Chronos up onto the two supports. Should be such easy pickups here. Chaotic Offering comes down. Double Golem. Is it gonna be enough? Chaos Meteor onto Ohio. KYXY actually runs away from it. DDC goes down. He doesn't have buyback anymore. Echo Slam was spent as well. Rex are still alive. They're actually defending this. Although Mushi, he's just gonna get flame break into the Fissure. Now Lance, time walks away from KYXY Static Link. But the Rex survived. Mushi, he bought back as well. He wants to get somebody forced up Xiang Xi actually into the enemy base instead. Under the tier 4s.
Xiang Xi, wrong base, my friend. Wrong base. But I mean, he did what he had to do. He was, I don't know, buying the time to get the retreat here. But oh, nice Fissure and Blink out by Mr. Mosun, but oh, Mushi blinking right after him, but unfortunately he did not get the reality rift or the chaos balled up. So I mean, they still defend their axe, only lose the tier 3 tower, or they did that already before. Still, the buybacks are quite limited now, because the only one who is buyback is the Warlock, and I don't know, with a Aghanim Scepter Ice Blast, is that level 3 already? Jesus, yes, it is just level 3. He just inked level 16. With that, they also have enough counter push, so I don't think Titan can even dare to dream of pushing right now.
And did this game Arrow? Yes, they didn't get the Rex, but I don't think they care all too much. Suddenly, there's an Aghanim Scepter picked up on Earthshaker. Faceless Void finally finished his own as well. mean, triple Agonist Scepter on one team, Boots of Travels up on DDC's Invoker now as well, and just before this fight, I took a small look at the hero level chart. It's kind of devastating. I mean, Disruptor is still level 9. His absolute fodder this game. KYX are gonna get hit by the Ice Blast as well. Fisher actually comes out, and he has to go back to base. There's no other way around it.
Look at this. I mean, this is a level 3 Ice Blast with KYXY being well,
There's no escaping this. No escape.
Yep. All you need is like Ice Blast hit and then whatever else collateral damage, and that should be just enough. They want to go top here, and they might actually find Lance there. There's the stun. It's 4 seconds. That's of course good news, but the Warlock already running away because they're well aware that there is a Chronosphere, and at the moment he doesn't even use it. He just goes for the Ragclicks on Mushi here, but the entire team is coming. There's the Chronosphere. The Ice Blast is not going to connect, but still, it should be enough on Mushi. Yes, it is. Look at the duration of that Chronosphere. It feels like forever, and now you want to go for Ohio. In the meantime, we have, of course, Ned dying. That's not even an achievement. That is actually against the law because he can't really help himself there. And the GG call is coming out. Witchdog, last survivor. And he can tell the tale.
Echo Slam, man. Need to farm those creeps before game ends. Echo Slam.
But yeah, this is a surprise to me. Like, Arrow Gaming looking good. And the fun part is that, like, when we looked in the laning stage of the game, DDC didn't look that well in his lane. Like, I mean, he was driven out by the Razor multiple times, but then this 4-man committed gank from the Razor, that gave DDC time to finish his Midas, and from there on he found so much farm. And I don't know, the plays just didn't work out. Mushi not tanky enough, the Razor not tanky enough, and overall, like, they just fell twice for amazing bait by Arrow Gaming. Like, did you see just standing there like, la la la, let's go, and everybody was jumping him, but the Chronos was like, bye bye guys, that's it. Either way, guys, there is a second game waiting for you, and Kaji will tell you the rest.
Yes, guys, we are going into game number 2, but until then, if you did like what we did, then you, of course, can follow us on this channel, as well as HeflaTV 1 and HeflaMock, the English channel for us. And if you want to find out more info about future casts, you can follow us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, all of them are HeflaTV, and the votes directly uploaded onto our YouTube, youtube.com/HeflaMock. The links are below the stream as well. And you can always subscribe if you want to just get the best emotes out there. But guys, see you in gaming number 2.